How do you feel when you watch this? I know that wasn't on the list of questions, but how do you feel when you watch this?
I'm sort of hoping that people who watch this take away two things from it. One is that I'm hoping that they learn about the power of hydroponics and how it can be used to create a more sustainable method of farming. But I also hope that they learn that the conflict between Arab and Jewish populations in Israel is not hopeless, and that there are organizations like Sindyanna that are working to create peace between them.
Beautiful. Okay, so a little context. Could you talk a little bit about when you first visited Sindyanna, how you got there, why you went there, why your family decided to go visit? How did that happen?
Yeah, so we took a trip to Israel in the summer of 2019, and we were looking to visit some organizations, hoping to give back to the community, and Sindyanna was one of them. And what really inspired me about Sindyanna was, first of all, being able to see firsthand Arab and Jewish women being able to collaborate with one another and being able to create peace between them, but also just being inspired by their mission and trying to take on such a complex task like creating peace between two communities.
So what was the first moment of inspiration? What was your aha moment when you were there? They showed you around, they explained what they do, and when did that moment happen that you thought, I need to be doing this too?
Yeah, so it really happened when there were two people who were touring us around the visitor center. One was an Arab woman and one was a Jewish woman. And it was really inspiring to be able to see two women of conflicting communities being able to work together for something as small as touring my brother and I around this visitor center.
Did they let you participate at all, or was it just sort of a show and tell the first time you were there?
It was mostly a show and tell.
So we discussed this a little bit when we spoke. Why do you think women started this project? I mean, I know the it's a gentleman, right, an Israeli gentleman, but why women?
The way that Sindyanna explained this to me was that women in general are more, I guess, available or more accepting of other communities or more able to create peace between them. And that's how they explained it to me.
Has that been your experience?
I didn't really work with Sindyanna on their hydroponics project, but I have worked on a couple other projects with women.
It just brings to mind a wonderful book that I've shared with some of the families in our youth program. Are you familiar with Yuval Noah Harari? So it's okay if you're not. I'm not putting you on the spot. Yuval Noah Harari wrote Sapiens, and he also wrote a children's book, a version of that, and it's called Unstoppable Us. And Unstoppable Us, he's a historian, he's a philosopher, and the message from Unstoppable Us is the message of the ability of human beings to cooperate. We're the only species that can intentionally cooperate, make a plan, and carry it out, right? The cooperation can be for good or for evil. But I think this is a perfect example of how the intention gets set and the cooperation is extraordinary. What comes out of human cooperation for good is extraordinary. You have to have the vision, right? The first step after deciding to do this, okay, you came back, you were thinking about it, then what happens?
Yeah, so I learned that I kept in touch with Hadass Lahav, who's the founder of Sindyanna, and she, a little bit later, she introduced me to Sindyanna's hydroponics project. So I started doing a little bit of research about the project and about hydroponics, and I was really interested in hydroponics in general and creating a more sustainable method of farming. And that's when I got in touch with Volcani International Partnerships, which is another organization in Israel that I visited in the same summer on the same trip. And they introduced me to the Milosova food pantry, where I proceeded to use some funds from my bar mitzvah to install a hydroponic system there.
Amazing. So pandemic shut down, of course. You were establishing a new program and a new project, that's what led to the film, right? You were sort of stuck here and you wanted to move this forward. So what was the first step to sort of moving the project from Israel to something that you're doing in New York City? You want to talk about that?
Yeah, so when I got done with installing the hydroponic system at the food pantry in Tel Aviv, after that, I met a woman named Topeka Sam. She came to my school for an assembly, and she told us her story about how she created this organization called the Ladies of Hope Ministries, which hopes to prevent the poverty and incarceration of women worldwide. And I was inspired by her and her mission. And she also inspired me to bring hydroponics locally to New York. And the hydroponics I installed at the Hope House at the Ladies of Ministries, that was the first hydroponics system that I installed in New York.
And where is that? Where is the Hope House?
That's in the Bronx.
And subsequently, I understand there's another one, yes?
Yeah. That one we installed about a year ago. That's at the Young Men, Young Women Hebrew Association of Washington Heights. And we built a hydroponic system there. I volunteer there now every Thursday because it's very close to my school. And I teach the little children there how to operate the hydroponic system. And we donate the produce that we harvest to low-income and disabled elderly seniors at their Wien House program.
How was that site selected? I'm just curious. How did you get connected?
Yeah, so Anat Barber, she's from the UJA, and the UJA has a partnership with the Y, and she saw my film, and she was wondering if we could do a partnership to install a hydroponic system at the at their location.
And so during the week, this is something that needs to be tended every day, regularly monitored. Who does that in between?
Yeah, so we did alongside installing the actual system, we also do an online training program that only takes a few hours. And from then on, even though I volunteer there, it's mostly the people at the Y itself that are maintaining the system, and they do a very good job.
Is there sort of someone in charge? I'm just wondering how that works.
Yeah, so the main person who kind of maintains the hydroponic system, her name is Megan, and she's also the person that I work with on Thursdays.
In terms of logistics, so if a place wants a hydroponic system, what would be the first step? Obviously, there has to be funding, but what are the steps that have to happen between the idea and the plants growing?
Yeah, so we go there with with a bunch of measuring tools to kind of select the best room, and then we measure out that room and see how many hydroponic systems can fit in it and how big the systems can be. And then after that, we use the funding to order the parts. That normally takes a few weeks. And once the parts arrive, we all come in and we install the hydroponic system. And normally a day earlier or a day after, we do the training program. And on the day of the installation, we normally plant a few seeds in the grow rack that we use. And that's how it all kind of starts.
Really interesting. You make it sound so easy, like anybody can do this. Is it an anybody can do this thing?
Yeah, I think it really is. It's pretty simple once you get to knowing how to learn how to operate the hydroponic system. And what's really great about it is that because you can't really farm if you're living in an apartment, but with the hydroponic system, you can have a hydroponics tower in your apartment. It doesn't take up a lot of space, and you can grow your own food throughout the entire year.
So what's next for you? You have some interesting projects coming up. What's going to happen next in your life?
Yeah, so I sort of have two projects coming up right now. One is at a local minimum security prison for women in Danbury, and we're going to be installing the hydroponic system there in collaboration with the Federal Bureau of Prisons. And then another is very close to my school as well. It's at the Moshaloo Montfiore Community Center. They're a community center that distributes produce to low-income Manhattan residents 4 times a month, and we're hoping to help that by installing a hydroponic system there as well.
I'm curious, how did you get connected to the prison project? Was that your idea, or did somebody approach you?
Yeah, so it's also going to be in collaboration with the LOHM, with Topeka Sam. She thought it would be a great idea to install a hydroponic system at this prison as well, and I also thought it would be a wonderful plan.
Wonderful. Can you talk a little bit about fundraising? How does that happen?
Yeah, so I mean, I've had a few fundraising efforts. The biggest one was at my bar mitzvah in 2022. But other than that, we fundraised through some film festivals that I submitted my documentary to, and then also through some awards that I've received.
Amazing. What are your plans? We're not done. Really impressive. What are your plans for the summer coming up? And if you would share future plans, what do you think about? Where do you see yourself in the world in your future?
For future plans, I'm not really sure yet. I know I'm interested in documentaries, and I'm also interested in hydroponics. But for the summer, what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be installing the hydroponic system at the Moshaloo Montfiore Community Center. That's going to happen very recently on June 12th, so in just a few days. But other than that, we're also planning to install the hydroponic system at the Danbury Prison sometime by the end of the year.
Do you have any advice for young people? We have some young people in the room. Do you have questions? Well, let's see if he has advice for you, and then maybe you can ask a question. What would you say to them if they have, like, the next great idea?
Well, I really think that, like, you really need to try and find your passion and find what you're interested in, because that's the thing that you're going to perform the best at, and that's what you're really going to be motivated to do.
And I'm guessing you have a supportive family behind you, yeah?
Yeah.
We have any questions at all? And I'll give preferential treatment to the young people in the room. Jesus, you'll have to wait. You don't qualify. Do we have a young person question?
Testing.
Okay. We'll take a youngish person question. Jesus? Youngish.
Hello? Yeah. Yes. All right. So just curious about, like, if, for example, if I imagine most of us live in an apartment, right? And if you wanted to do something like this and you had a wall like the size behind him, that kind of area, is that something suitable to do something like this?
Yeah, it's definitely suitable. You can probably put like a hydroponics tower just in the corner of your room that probably isn't taking up much space. And you can get different like sizes depending on how high the ceiling is. And you can also get like just a small little hydroponics box. They sell those online. There are a bunch of different ways, but hydroponics in general really saves space.
Yeah, how much would that be? Yeah, I mean, that's the practical thing, right? I mean.
Yeah, so I mean, the towers that we use, they're around like 7 feet high, and each of those are probably around $1,000. But you can also like build your own hydroponic system or order like a smaller kit online, and that'll be in like probably around $100 to $200.
Hi, is there a place where we can see one, where it's, you know, where we can actually go and see it happening? I don't care. I just want to see what it looks like.
Where I really got interested in hydroponics in New York was, I forget the name of the building, but I went to a building. It was a new building, and they were installing a hydroponic system there. And that's how I actually met my hydroponic supplier in New York. I forget the address or the name of the building, but there are a lot of different places that you can go see hydroponics in New York.
Maybe you can send us some links afterwards. Okay, if anyone's interested in doing a field trip. I know I'm going to give a shout out to Steve Serling's school. The High School for Environmental Justice has a hydroponic, beautifully functioning hydroponic system. And I think High School for Environmental Studies has one as well. At Trinity, you have one. Do you have one at your school, by the way?
No.
And why not?
I don't know. Maybe sometime soon.
Do you think hydroponic can be used to feed poor people around the world?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, the main thing that we're doing with hydroponics at Growing Peace is we're installing them in places of need so that we can get as much as we can out of the systems. And like, for example, at the food pantry in Israel, it's a food pantry that services Eritrean and Sudanese asylum seekers that flee their country hoping for a better life in Israel. But unfortunately, because they're not quite citizens yet, they don't have as many rights as normal citizens, and so they often find it hard to put food on the table for their families. And so the hydroponic system there feeds them. And as long as you choose a good location to put the hydroponic system, you can really help communities in need.
I notice that there's a lot of plastic in the hydroponic gardening, and I just wanted to ask about that. Like, I noticed that I get this little, oof, but it's made of plastic. Can you help me with that?
Yeah, I mean, unfortunately, we do have to use, like, plastic for this particular kind of hydroponic system, because that's kind of like, that's one of the best materials for hydroponics. But I know it's unfortunately like not very sustainable, but we hope to kind of cancel out that effect with the benefits of hydroponics regarding sustainability, such as it doesn't use soil, which is very good because we're running out of fertile soil because of climate change. It uses a lot less water because we can recycle the water and just add more nutrients to it. It uses less space. You can produce the plants year-round. There are just a bunch of different benefits that we're hoping to cancel out, but unfortunately we have to use the plastic to build the systems.
I think when we're talking, I'm sorry, David, and just want to follow up. When we're talking about choices and solutions, sometimes it's the better choice, and the solutions are not perfect. And I think that's one of those moments where, you know, plastic still exists, and how do we mitigate the other contributors to climate change, for example. And if we grow food locally, we eliminate a lot of carbon from transportation and all of the other things Stephen said, water and so forth. So we make better choices, and until something comes along that is not plastic that we can use.
No, thanks, Monica. Stephen, thanks so much for your great work. I'm just amazed. So I'm rethinking my 30 or so potted plants, for one thing, in my studio apartment. I love them, but, you know, the soil has to be changed out. The soil itself comes in unrecyclable plastic bags, right? I mean, so that's one plastic that's probably totally eliminated. I imagine, too, you can reuse the particular plastic containers in some cases. So, I mean, reusing it is... The real question I have, so let me get this and I'll be quiet. The soil thing, right? I'm pretty old-fashioned when it comes to believing soil is absolutely essential to healthy veggies, right? Okay, phosphorus, potassium, whatever, nitrogen and stuff don't come necessarily with the water. So do you have a sense of whether the veggies you grow are as healthy and as tasty or both?
So, I mean, what we do is normally it would require soil. But instead of soil, we basically, how hydroponics work is we fill water with the nutrients that are normally in soil, and we take that water and pass it through the roots of the plants, and that gives it the nutrients that it needs.
One last question. Matthew. Oh, Danny's, we need the microphone so that
the stranger.
Really interesting, brilliant, proud of you. We all are. Keep doing what you're doing. Have you come across permaculture projects and possible ways of sort of mending and crossing over the efforts of permaculture with the efforts of hydroponics to address sustainability challenges for the future? Because I think the solution is it's those two types of innovative agricultural methods.
Yeah, so I mean, I visited an organization in Israel called New York Sunworks. They install these permaculture and hydroponic farming solutions, and the site that I visited was at, I was on the roof of a public school in New York, and they had a bunch of different kind of methods of farming that involved both hydroponics and permaculture, but I'm not sure if this was one of them, but one that I found very interesting was they used the like the nutrients that fish produced in the tank, and they used that as the food supply for the plants. But I think hydroponics and permaculture in general can be used to create a much more sustainable farming solution.
I just had not a question, but just a comment. I just want to say your work is fantastic. I'm very, very impressed with what you're doing. And I just want to say I think it's absolutely terrific. You've brought this to the Washington Heights Y. I've been the executive director of this organization now for almost 19 years. But prior to coming here, I was the associate executive director of the Washington Heights Y for about 17 years. As great of an organization as this is, they're also a great organization, and you bringing this to them just makes them that much better. So I am very, very pleased that you're doing that. And I'm sorry, I don't really have any affiliation with them anymore. I still live in the neighborhood of the Y, a couple blocks away. But anyway, great news. Great to hear.
Thank you.
So Bob is your guy, because we're going to do a hydroponic system here now, right, Bob? So Bob's your guy. Connect with Bob. We're going to make this happen. Okay, so thank you so much again, Stephen. And hang around for lunch. And thank you for being here today and for your amazing work. Thank you.
Thank you. It's an honor to be here.